Hello, good day. Welcome back to my very relaxing hot tub time. Tubesdays are back, folks. Oh yeah. That's a tube right there. I, you know, some people say it's not sanitary bringing your tube into the hot tub. I say whatever, man. I'm vaccinated. Invincible. That's a side effect of the vaccination, is invincibility. I am sure you all understand that. It's science! Welcome! It's great, great to have you here. Wow. Oh my goodness. Look at us go on a unsuspecting Tuesday. Who'd have thought? They're back. At least for this week. Maybe next week. Who knows? Maybe we'll get our asses kicked in XCOM. Maybe not, though. Thanks for being here. Exactly. Space Kid gets it. You know, you can clean your tube while you relax. You know, very good. You know, we're here. We're doing our Tuesday thing again, just because for the heckin' joy of it, because I really like to play XCOM, and it's also really fun to you know, gamble with your lives. What do I mean by that? Of course, it's because well, you guys are making soldiers. Scooty Puff, man, you got into XCOM? Were you into XCOM before that? That's fucking great. Okay, so I only just started creating soldiers from our top donors, but I also want to expand it to subs. So we're gonna start with those of you. We're gonna start with those of you who are like, we're gonna start from the top up, I guess. You know, we gotta go the longest running nerds. So if you are 20 months or over, if you've been subbed for 20 months or over, I wanna make a soldier of you. And we're gonna eventually, as the game goes on, as the campaign goes on, we're gonna need more and more nerds to create soldiers, because an army is comprised of a bunch of nerds, right? So I know it was kind of like not very unclear last week, or I guess on Friday, how to like what do I do to, if I have a soldier, if what do I do to like customize it? Okay, so you're just gonna email. Just friggin' email me. It's so easy. It's with the, you know, the clickety clack. It's like you got one of these things. Yeah, I got a keyboard in my hot tub. It's fucking, it likes to chill. It likes to relax too, you know? Yeah, so just email me like some broad strokes. You can, there's also some clips. There's also some clips in the video section in this Twitch channel, where you can go through and like look at all the customization options and just email me with any fucking info you want. It can be as detailed or as like, you know, as undetailed as you want. If you want to just be like randomly generated, but like be the color red, you can do that. That's fine. And just let me know like your name and stuff, like whatever you want it to be called. So anyway, yeah. So if you're 20 months and up, you know, just hit me up. What's up? You know, it's Corbleese. Thank you so much for the yes, that is the correct email. Corb's got it. Speaking of which, Corb, what the hell, man? You gotta freaking let me know. What's your soldiers? Your soldiers just there, being auto-generated, like a fucking ding dong, you know. So yeah, anyway, for those of you, who are just here for the fun, the heckin' fun, you know, welcome in, thank you so much. If you don't have 20 months, don't worry about it. We're gonna be whittling our way down. I just want to give, you know, I want to give the priority to the nerds who have been with us the longest, you know? I think it's the only fair way to go. Is there a YouTube video with all the character customizations? I couldn't find a good one. Maybe I'm looking for the wrong thing. I mean, it shows. I found one that didn't include the DLC, but I mean, that's probably more than enough, you know, whatever. Anyway, whatever. What we're listening to right now, folks, or what we have been listening to, is some frickin' Planet Booty. They just dropped a new album today. It's frickin' rad, of course. And Twerp played on one of these tunes on Only If You Say Yes, you know? So anyway, but without further ado, we're gonna get right in. Wow, look at this hype train. A Tuesday night hype train. You guys are just fantastic. I don't care what they say about you guys. I like you. You know, you're kind of crazy, but I like you. You know, you're crazy, but I like you guys. What am I saying here? As is tradition here in the Corn Zorn, half of all of our tips today are going to charity. We are supporting Haiti earthquake relief because that is an ongoing crisis that, you know, conveniently you just don't hear about, really. But no, shit's still fucked there. So let's toss a coin that way. So everybody, what do you say? What do you say we freaking do it? Should we get into it? Wow, this level four. You guys are I'm gonna start taking back some of the things I've said about you guys. Level four on a Tuesday night, it's wild. You're not so bad. I don't care what they say about you guys. All right, before we do that, I'm just gonna knock off a couple of these shouties here. Shiro, thank you so much for the 22 months. Ow! I can't believe it. Yeah, and you got a milestone with your first Bandcamp royalties. Congratulations. That's freaking rad. Good for you. Mysterious Basis, 11 months. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Barkley, hey, what's up? Thank you so much. Happy Tuesday. Hype for some more XCOM? That's the spirit. That's what I want to heard. Do you remember the 21st? Ah! Oh! I do remember. That's going in the bunker playlist. what a coinkydink, folks, because I literally just stumbled across their social media like yesterday. And I was like, wow, social media for Earth, Wind & Fire, a band that's like 50 years old. And I followed the shit out of that. Hell yeah. Anyway, lest we get DMCA'd, whatever. All right, just a little taste. Yeah, they're on social media. I know, it's crazy, right? All right, so let's get into it. Netty, thank you for the 9. Toad Sensi for the 22. Thank you so much. That's nuts. Hey, so that's an example. Toad, if you want to have an XCOM soldier, you're gonna email me, follow some, like, just freaking YouTube XCOM character customization, and just let me know, like, you know, some details, like, whatever. And, you know, yeah, whatever. Okay, thank you for those 22. Funk, thank you. By the way, Funk, you got a soldier here. You're awaiting some customization. Thank you, for the fiver. Should be on the lookout for some new apparel. Oh, fantastic. I will be. Mysterious, right on. Thank you so much for that gifty. Thank you so much. That's so kind of you. And sup, it's Carrie. Hey, do you remember? You, gosh darn right, I remember. All right, let's get into this. Let's get into it, shall we? Is this gonna work? Look at that. Wow. Look at this. That's some official Cornzorn merchandise right there. Oh yeah, drinking some hot tea tonight. Mm-hmm. Limited edition Cornzorn mug. Stay rad out there. Bring some orange spice. It's nice. Okay. So I'm trying to. Okay. So just a little recap of what we did. That's old merch. That is old merch. Yeah, that's from over a year ago now. Did the green screen just fuck with the mug?
Asking you, doctor, but what exactly did you do before the invasion?
At one time, I was employed as a biochemist in the pharmaceutical industry, mainly researching.
Oh, but now, yeah, like if you're swirling, power to you. I'm not swirling on a Tuesday night, you know. I try to, you know.
I saw firsthand what their technology.
Keep it clean, you know. On the Tuesday.
Lucky to have you with us.
I appreciate the sentiment.
Okay, so recap. Last time we did two missions. We aced Gatecrasher, which is the first mission. Then we also completed our second mission. It was a completed mission, technically, yes. We had the boldness to bring two rookies, and it cost us dearly in the form of a life. We lost Escher Bug, rest in pepperonis. So, you know,
Commander, we have a lead on the alien black site, but we'll have to rely on the local resistance to actually get us into the facility. We should try to make contact with their forces in the region as soon as possible. It's the only way we're going to find out what's behind this so-called Avatar project.
Yeah, Laura did kind of miffed a couple of shots, I think, but we can't place all the blame on Laura all. Okay, so we can investigate that soldier. So I'm like, it's been, I play a lot of XCOM, but I play the modded version called Long War 2, and it's, I should not let this play out. It's really fucking hard. It's the hardest version of what I believe is the hardest game. And that is, that's why I played. I'm a sucker for the,
Avenger plotting new course.
Make contact with this here scientist. And so there's a few very fundamental differences, in terms of like the game mechanics and whatnot. I'm gonna let these first cinematics play for all you new nerds out there.
If only I had known.
Ah, Commander.
That's the chip extracted from the Commander.
There's been some progress. I've managed
Which
to
is
break
me.
Down several key components of the chip implanted.
Hey, that's my skull.
My analysis reveals
the dimensions are a little off.
Was that of a conduit,
little less conical,
passing a vast amount of data directly to your cerebral cortex. With the primary connection severed, much of that data is lost. Several fragments do remain, however. Ghosts, if you will. Observe. Tactical combat simulations. War games.
That's from the first XCOM.
The encounters you were processing was astounding. It is truly remarkable that you survived as long as you did. Though this may seem disconcerting,
War
there
games.
Is still some good news. This chip bears a striking resemblance to a medical implant I briefly assisted in developing at the gene therapy clinic in New Providence. My understanding was that the implants were intended for high-ranking Advent officers only, captains or above. Retrieving a chip from such an officer would be the only way to know for certain. A greater understanding of these implants would undoubtedly benefit us all.
Game audio is quiet. Sorry, I'll turn that up in just a sec.
New objective added.
Let's turn that just a touch. Yeah, I'll give it a little bit more mustard. Just a little bit more mustard on that mustard. how's this? Okay, let's try that now.
The admin officers have clearly been modified to allow for their subordinates to receive new orders psionically. The implanted chip is the
key. So, by the way, we are, I think today we are gonna get to reveal my soldier, who is one of the hero classes. He's a Templar. He's a fucking psionic martial artist. No big deal. I mean, it's pretty badass, but it's no big deal. To my great disappointment, even within the modding community, there are no mullets. Because the XCOM 2 has a humongous mod community, like mod workshop community. And there was not a single mullet. Not even in the base game, not in the expansion, the DLC, nowhere in the mod community. It's fucking bullshit, if you ask me, you know? Pardon my French, but... Okay, so yeah, we got a new facility available. Okay, so my strategy is going to be pretty questionable, but I'm a huge sucker for psionic psi soldiers, you know? So I'm going to try and rush the psi lab so that I can get my soldiers melting aliens with their minds, because I think that's really cool. Think like 11 from, like, you know, Stranger Things, you know? It's just like that. So we gotta get this resistance communications on the giggity go so that we can expand.
Stemming from this technology.
Okay.
I'll have a report assembled as soon as the research is complete.
We've done what we can to honor our fallen soldiers, Commander.
Did I freeze?
People a chance to pay their respects.
Advent Burger, serving humanity with a side of fries.
Is Twitch just being a ding dong? So here we can take a look at our fallen soldiers. Escherbug, rest in peace. We hardly knew ye. It was quite a pickle we found ourselves in, because Escherbug got disoriented by a sectoid and couldn't run away fast enough from the zombie. Didn't even get to customize yet. Oh man, thank you. Yes, I'm so excited to customize more nerds. By the way, there are a few in here. I'll give you a quick overview of the ones that I did. I don't know my... There we go. Via my soldiers. So Space Kid, there you are. You're blue. With a headband. That's dope. Where else? Yeah, Tiny Tuba looking real evil. Very cool. Who else? Oh. Shit. Nethy, I think I changed it in the character pool, but not in this game. But, Mysterious Bassist? I'll get to you later, Nethy, in here. And then, sup, it's Carrie. Purple with shades, very cool. Alright. So yeah, there's a whole bunch, there's more to come. Of course, if you're on this list, if you're a nerd watching this stream right now and you're on this list, please email me some stuff. There's also more nerds here. Lady Katie, Yoshi the Shiba, Corbliss, Sarah Scary, MD, and then these nerds are gonna get replaced by other nerds by like 20 month subscribers and whatnot. So, I should probably make a Discord channel for this, shouldn't I? That would be so much easier. James Wood. Isn't James Wood an asshole? I'm pretty sure he's an asshole. Alright. I've just been gabbing. We wanna collect this scientist. So we're scanning this area with the Avenger. That's our ship. Really want that scientist. Ooh, that's nice.
Thank you for sending additional support staff to assist me, Commander.
So we just get to keep scanning?
Sure they are put to good use.
That's wild. I should go collect this soldier. So this is our first starting region right here, the Western U.S. Eastern U.S. is connected, but we can't make contact with them to start doing missions there until we get resistance communications.
Avenger plotting new course.
So yeah, we're trying to get scan these sites, these points of interest, as it were.
Too trusting,
John. Oh, everybody pay attention.
Advent is the enemy. The enemy is food.
Recognize.
Try not to bring
that voice.
We meet, Volk.
You take their side after all we've seen these years.
Look, I'm not exactly having drinks with them, but they did hold up their end of the bargain. What about you?
Wait and see. Volk out.
I'll give you a A hint. That's the voice of someone from Star Trek.
That was Konstantin Volokov, Volk to his friends. He and his Reapers are a big part of the reason why you're standing here today. Volk may be a little rough around the edges, but he's the real deal. Heads one of three resistance groups operating independently from us that we
Templars.
Consider a threat to Advent. Together, they'd make one hell of a fighting force. Too bad they hate each other. Still, we've made some unlikely progress. Volk's Reapers may have found you, but they weren't acting alone. They were tipped off by a group of Advent defectors known as the Skirmishers.
Now, that was the voice of Patrick Stewart. You're all wrong.
With these guys, knowing where they came from. But you wouldn't be here without...
Actually, it was the voice of,
Both the Reapers and the Skirmishers have agreed to suspend hostilities, provided you serve as the go-between. Trust doesn't come easy between these two, so we're heading for a nice, quiet spot on neutral ground. Even so, let's not take any chances. Intel on this area is weak, and we're picking up strange
channels. Yeah, that's right,
comms. Not to mention we're ending a decade-long blood feud today. I'd advise our soldiers to be fully prepared before we deploy on this one.
Yes, I'm so excited.
Good luck.
Also,
we're all friends now. Maybe you could lend my people a hand in dealing with a problem of ours.
Not sure how long our contacts are going to
Oh my god, we're gonna get another scientist from this?
So I'd recommend we proceed as soon as possible.
Yeah.
All available soldiers are standing by to deploy.
Setting course for Western United States.
What was I gonna say?
Each faction has agreed to allow a two-person squad to escort them to the rendezvous point.
Okay.
Hopefully that should be enough to keep them from killing each other. We've got a temporary ceasefire in place for the duration of the meet, but still, that doesn't mean we shouldn't be ready for anything.
Okay. So, we can only bring two normal soldiers. I think I definitely want to bring a sharpshooter for this mission. And... Perhaps a ranger? Let's take a look at these bonds, because it's good to send nerds who are compatible with each other. It's good to send the nerds together. So let's take a look at Space Kids bonds. Really high with Lana. I think we better not bring two sharpshooters. Let's bring a ranger. Because the sharpshooter's pistol, I'm pretty sure, if I recall correctly, I'm pretty sure is like so good on this mission. I think we're just gonna go ahead. There's not much else we can do, right? Yeah. Okay. You know what? No, I don't want the ranger. Bring the specialist, sure. Oh, there's two squads! Oh, snap! Snap. Okay, so let's go back. I guess I am just gonna bond these two sharpshooters. No, I can't do that. That's too crazy! It can't be done. It's too crazy. Let's go like this. Okay? Very good. Let's do the rendezvous, guys! Let's do the rendezvous! A relationship can be two sharpshooters? You know what? That's forbidden. That is taboo. Because sharpshooters need a spotter, dude. You think two sharpshooters up in a nest are gonna get anything done? When they're compatible? No! They're just gonna end up playing cards and... cracking jokes.
Have been at each other's throats for years, so we're keeping the exact meeting point strictly need to know.
You'll split into two squads, rendezvous with each faction, and bring their envoy directly to the location.
Ruins of Seattle.
Officially, this city no longer exists, so we don't expect a lot in the way of Advent resistance. Still, keep your eyes peeled. It's been about 20 years since we last stepped foot in this place.
All right. Since I've played the expansion. This is an expansion mission. This is like the intro.
If you are hungry, there's more where that came from.
Recognize that voice?
Impressive reflexes, but unnecessary.
Stand down. We're all friends here.
You are safe here.
Space Kid, you're in Seattle? Well, it's not looking too great.
More so than you imagine. We shall see if the same holds true for these skirmishers of yours.
You're right, that is Mark Wahlberg's voice. No, just kidding, it's Elijah Wood.
Your presence already disturbs them. We must move quickly. My people will take care of this camp. Come.
Post-apocalyptic kind of stuff here.
Uploading the coordinates to the rendezvous point now. We've plotted the most direct route there. We don't know much about the skirmisher contact you'll be meeting other than his name. Mox.
Mox.
Oh, yes.
Praetor Mox. His death squads wiped out entire camps of my people in the first years of the war. You would dare do this?
Pretty sure hands are bloody on both sides of this fight.
Reaper Shadow.
Reapers
have
in the cold, harsh world that was
advanced. Whoa, Reapers have advanced stealth.
Long-range attacks, and our marksmen are unmatched by even the best XCOM has to offer. Damaged and dormant all these years, these devices still emit trace elements of unstable radiation.
Oh, I forgot. That's rad.
I cannot fathom what they were like. Their original function.
Those are things from the from XCOM 1.
You're better off having missed it.
Yeah.
Roger that.
I recognize it.
In movimento.
Hey, I can't wait to see you in Houston, Tejas. War Beast, thanks for stopping by. Can't wait to rock.
I'm just
gonna be moving along here. Just moving along.
Ci vado subito.
The Lost. Oh. Radiation alien zombies!
We are not alone!
No!
Things. They still look like people.
What was human died years ago. Only the taint of the aliens survives now. Where there is one, more will follow. You must not hesitate to destroy them.
These creatures' DNA has mutated well beyond what we would classify as human. Perhaps the result of long-term exposure to the alien radiation from those pods.
So we need to get
anyone would subject
way over here.
That. I cannot imagine.
When the governments fell, millions starved. Many fled to cities such as this to scavenge for food.
Oh, brutal, dude.
Not heed the
okay,
warning.
So, if I can remember correctly, I'm pretty sure that the zombies, the Lost, can't climb up the ladders if, if you're blocking the ladder. So, I would really like to, I guess we're gonna test that theory out right now. They might have patched it. Can anybody tell me if that's true? Cause, I don't want, Yeah, everybody knows exactly. The best way to kill zombies is by going up a ladder. Okay, so we're gonna ascend this ladder. I am XCOM Jesus, but you know, even Jesus didn't have like all the answers all the time. Just like most of the time. Alright, we're just gonna run like hell. That's what we're gonna do.
No time to spare.
And we're gonna test my theory. If I remembered correctly. Okay. I'm gonna giddy up. Up her. Did that just attract more nerds? Yeah, okay. That's fine. So these nerds can still access this top floor up there, so let's try this out. I could be totally wrong and this could go very poorly. He fell down. Zombie fell down.
My people have encountered these beings before.
So first, I'm pretty sure that they may appear, yeah, they can't come up here.
But they hear quite well. Great numbers, they can be very deadly.
I'm gonna continue to test this theory. Continue. So we're gonna shoot it with a pistol. Okay, so here's why I wanted to bring the sharpshooter. Headshot chaining. When an XCOM unit kills a lost unit with a standard attack, that unit receives an additional action point. By carefully selecting targets, a soldier can kill several lost and still move normally. Right. I remember this mechanic now. Very good. So I think we are just gonna keep booking it, right? I think we're just gonna keep booking it. Yeah, let's just keep booking it.
Ricevuto, mi muovo.
We're gonna take a peek with our concealed nerd. Ooh. Don't want to attract more of those nerds. And yet, I feel like we are going to do that. Let's open this door. I also forget if these zombies can... I also forget if they can... move and then attack. Or if they have to... like move up to you so that they're adjacent to you and then a separate move to attack, because they only get two actions. So we're just gonna keep freaking running like hell. I think we're just gonna, we don't want to give away this nerd's position, so we're just gonna
moving as ordered.
Take our time. These nerds are gonna run up. The reason why I did that move is because
an entire city of our own people.
It's because I don't want them to see my Reaper and then get revealed. Right? So what we're gonna do here is we're gonna just run right up, murk these nerds so that we can get them off our back, you know what I mean? We can guarantee to kill these nerds. So we're gonna try and conserve some ammo and some action economy by getting really close up. Like this.
Heading to that location.
Is that gonna do it? That didn't do it. That sucks. XCOM Jesus. So, unless I miss on one of these 97% shots, then we're safe. Okay, so Skull just laying out those zombie nerds. Yep, so I don't want to fight with Dragonova yet because we need to keep that concealment for as long as we can, because that's like a very valuable resource. Concealment is. Okay, we got some zombos over there.
These creatures are worse even than Advent. They have no cause,
hello?
No fear. They simply exist. If we do not defeat the aliens soon, we will become little more than they are.
Is there a way we can... Yeah, let's get over here. I like this zone. Can I get over to this zone? There's a door over here. Let's go over this way, because that's a little sketch of Rooney's. If we go here, I feel like we're going to attract a bunch of nerds. But if we jump down this way, that's no good. That's no good. So we're going to take the long route, be patient.
I go where
yeah,
I'm needed.
That's what we're going to do. Open this door. Looks pretty clear to me.
No one will cross.
Alright.
We risk all this for Praetel Mox? If he is not what you say he is, I shall kill him myself.
Looking forward to this meeting already.
Okay. So, we're gonna try not to aggro these guys until the very last moment. So, let's get over here.
Order's confirmed. On the move.
Try and get over this way, because this ladder is easily defended.
Extraction point is close, but looks like these things don't want to make it easy for you.
We will make it to your pet Advent in time.
Central, biological signatures are grouping into a singular mass. One closing in on this position.
Woo!
A swarm. We must push forward.
Sounds like
it arrives.
We better giddy up then, folks. So, here's a cool thing. So this Space Kid's pistol does 2 to 3 damage. And the thing about the pistol is that you don't need to reload it. Whereas down here, see down here, that's how much ammo is in our primary weapon. But the pistol is a sidearm and doesn't need to be reloaded. So we can just, like, chain these shots together using this pistol and not reload. That is called efficiency.
Enemy destroyed.
Four most beautiful words in the English language. Efficiency. That's right. So, Space Kid. Didn't quite kill the last one, but that's fine. We're still doing great. Now I can move down here.
I am at your service.
With our... Oh boy. So, what we're gonna do is we're gonna definitely not aggro those nerds. We're just gonna chill, and then next turn, we're gonna make a mad dash for the evac. Just gonna overwatch there. Yes, we need. Wait, do they know where we are? They weren't aggro, though. They don't know where we are. Oh, but that Overwatch fire coming in handy.
For years, my
all right, so here we go. We're gonna get the hell out of here. Now you risk run away! It's time to bravely run away.
If you haven't noticed, the aliens have been... You should have a clear path through now.
There
Second
we go.
Squad is already en route to Mox. Proceed to the rendezvous and await their arrival.
Oh, we'll be there.
Alright, very good. Okay, that's the first part of this mission. With our first little, you know what I mean. Squad! Time for squad 2!
Looks like trouble ahead. The rendezvous could be compromised. Stay focused.
Skirmishers are pretty badass too.
I'm guessing that's our man. Well, our contact anyway.
Crocsod. Advent. Hobbit. Rostala.
He's not winning any beauty contests.
They were sent here to hunt. To purge the Drakkar. The lost.
Recognize that voice?
Our meeting point is still secure. She is free of the imposter gods. I would give anything that all my kind could say the same. Even sit down with your reapers.
It is Adam Sandler. Very good. Very good.
We must go.
It is Worf.
Rendezvous with Outrider is further ahead.
No, it's not. It's not Kurt Russell. It's not Kurt Russell. Although,
something tells me this city still has a few more surprises.
Wait, wasn't Worf played by Kurt Russell?
The least of our worries today. It is these reapers of yours that are of true concern.
We, the skirmishers, were created by the false gods of this world.
So listen, if you want an explanation on what a skirmisher is.
We retain all that we were and more. And our prowess in battle serves us well in our cause. In close combat, none can stand opposed to us.
Right, so skirmishers are Advent soldiers. That's why they look. He looks all frigged up in his face. Because he is a genetic, whatchamacallit, you know? Genetically modified nerd, is what you'd call it technically. Yeah, so when the aliens came and they took over Earth, they, you know, took human DNA, frigged with it a bunch, made Advent. But then, eventually some of the Advent nerds, like the troopers and the officers and stuff, that's what they look like under this armor. They look the same as the skirmisher.
I will watch.
Pardon me. And yeah, some Advent nerds became self-aware or whatever, and like rebelled or whatever. You know what I mean. Just inching our way forward. Very good. Let these nerds walk this way. Shoot them! Get that nerd! Missed.
Not good.
Oh, we got an evil fire nerd. That's a fire nerd. Alright, nice shooting, dude.
We take from the Elder stock.
Okay, so we need to blow this nerd up. So, okay, so this is what's cool about these skirmishers. They have this grapple, which is a free move. I think it's a free move. Right? Yeah, it's a free move. And then we can, it gets you elevation, and it gets you flanking shots really easily. So that we can just, like, cancel out this nerd's high cover. Because see how he's got that red shield? That means he's in high cover, which gives us a 40% aim penalty. So it's really hard to shoot this nerd from behind that cover. So we're gonna a little zippy up here, just like so. And we're gonna shoot him now, because he's a bad nerd. We're gonna shoot this bad nerd. And we're gonna shoot him again.
Ammunition is low.
Hope we can kill him. That'd be nice. Oh! And how?
You said those tanks could explode. Careful with these things. We don't need to
so
take
we're gonna
any unnecessary chances.
The patrol
upper
has been liberated. May their lives not be lost in vain.
On this high ground.
We must push forward and complete our mission.
High ground is so important for, I guess these lost missions, because lost are just a bunch of freaking zombies, so cover doesn't really matter against them. So just having that high ground is, like, so important. Gonna, we'll load up before we advance. Okay. Okay, so we're gonna keep on going. How much is the cooldown on this grapple? Oh, I see. So we need to get over her. Alright. I wonder if there are more, fire nerds around.
Order confirmed. On the move.
I don't think so. I think there's just zombie nerds.
Okay,
so let's not get too quacky with our movement here. We're gonna just inch forward. And then get on Overwatch. Overwatch allows us to take reaction fire against anything that walks into our line of sight. Is good. Slow and steady, folks. Any more zombos? Oh, we can definitely blow that thing up.
This is no patrol. It's an army.
Yes, one we do not have time to face.
Everyone, get back!
Kaboom! It's a bold strategy, Cotton.
Purifiers may be down, but unfortunately, that was our extraction point.
Okay.
I fear that is not the worst of it.
Hold position.
Biological signatures rapidly on approach to your position.
Uh-huh.
The lost. The sounds of combat excite them.
Okay.
And you just blew up a fuel truck?
There was no other. Find an alternate exit. We will deal with the lost.
Oh yeah,
Dashers. They are not docile as the rest of their kind.
An
dash
description. It
right.
would seem the mutation has somehow accelerated these dashers' metabolism, allowing enhanced speed and agility with a corresponding increase in aggression.
So we are gonna get up again onto our high ground. Where's our friend? Oh, there's our friend. So we're gonna grapple up here. If we can get up to that, that'd be dope. I wonder if we can reach it. Can we? Not quite. That's too bad. But that's okay. I'm just gonna...
A useful aid.
Get up onto this crate here. Just get into position this turn, I guess. And, I'm not gonna take that shot. I'm just gonna get into position and let the nerds come to us. You know what I mean?
I stand ready.
Ooh, they are fast, though. Oh shit! Whoa! Okay, so they can now scale walls. Without the ladders. Okay.
The shockwave of that explosion reverberated throughout.
What do you have on your head? Are you talking to me? Well, this is a helmet.
From them is their deaths. Find us.
It's a long story. The short answer is yeah, music. Future avant-garde headpiece. Is this getting through to you? For real though, yes. I'm a nerd in a band. I'm from the future. And we like silly hats, you know? So let's murk some of these nerds.
No longer a threat.
Gotta clear some nerds.
Target neutralized.
Please kill this nerd. 4 damage is good. That's enough to kill it.
Draining ammo fast.
So the nerds over here. There's one nerd. So I'm pretty sure that this is new. Like, that these nerds can now scale like walls. Because I'm pretty sure before they could only go up ladders and shit. They must have finally patched it, realizing that it's totally broken. Or something. Oh, missed on that 76% shot. Lana, you make me sad. That makes me sad. It really does. I'm gonna do something down here. Hopefully we can kill this nerd. What does Justice do again? Use the grapple to pull a humanoid target to you and deliver a ripjack strike. Well, that sounds fun. We're definitely gonna do that. Or after we delete that nerd. And then we're gonna Justice this nerd. Like that. Nice, dude. Nice. Okay. I'm gonna reload and then Overwatch. Yep. Zerg King SC2.
Gonna need a little more time.
Bro, I'm a straight up Zerg man myself. I used to crush part of the swarm. I'm just gonna use our pistol as much as we can to eliminate these little nerds. The 2 hit point nerds. It's pretty much a guaranteed. Pretty much a guaranteed kill. You lost the game. What game did you lose? Wait, did that miss? Oh, wow. I wasn't paying attention and we totally missed, didn't we? Whoops! Yeah, that was a miss on a 95% shot, wasn't it? That's XCOM, yep.
Target eliminated.
Okay, shooting that nerd, shooting this nerd. Gonna reload and turn on
Overwatch.
Then up here. Oh, I should have moved, but whatever. That's fine. We're gonna grapple up in a turn anyway.
I will go. Reinitializing weapon.
Get into position.
We got something here. Just need another minute.
You have your minute.
Alright, bam. Reload. We can't see anything, so we're just gonna keep it chill. Like this.
Moving to designated coordinates.
Get up onto this box.
Readings are all over the place. The lost are almost right on top of
a lost swarm is very close.
Seem to be pretty sensitive to noise. The sounds of combat are likely to draw even more of them. We found a new route that should get you to the rendezvous point safely. The lost are still converging on the area, so make it fast.
Oh, let's get the hell out of here. Rip.
I move.
Is it safe to go up here?
Changing position.
I don't know if this is a bad idea or not. Are we gonna aggro some more nerds? No, we're good. Okay, so we're just gonna.
Got it covered.
run like hell this turn and try to escape.
C'est parti.
Are we talking like degrees of nerd here? I've got some potentially life-changing information for you that, you know, if you're here right now and you're watching this, you're a nerd. It's like, that's for sure.
As you command.
Yeah, that's a lot of zombies. We're gonna get the hell out of here.
Waiting for you ahead. I know this wasn't the easiest stop, but I have to believe it'll still be worth it in the end.
That depends on the Reapers.
All right, so part two. Down. I think there's a third part. And then. I know it's okay. It can be difficult to come to terms with that fact that you're a nerd.
Let's try and play nice today, people.
But just let it happen, man.
Brutal captain comes to atone for his crimes.
I am no longer that being. I am free now.
Taking off that helmet does not change what you are. Reapers have long memories, Elder Kruxod. Anytime.
The way I see it, we have two options. Join forces and kick the Elders off our world, or kill each other here and now. The choice is yours.
What? Don't do that. Oh, right.
No one has ever done that before. Oh. No one shall ever do that again.
Okay, so this is where...
What the hell is that?
Our campaign could go really badly.
Relentless death that stalks my kind. Butcher of free advent.
My people face another like her. They are the undying Advent's curse upon us.
Right.
We must combine strength if we are to have any chance of success.
You are welcome to try.
Okay, so... Okay. I just got goose pimples!
They appeared without warning years ago. Had they not... We would have already regained our home.
This is called XCOM War of the Chosen. That was the Chosen.
The Elder's will extends throughout the universe. I am but one of their instruments.
The assassin can fuck you up. She goes invisible, and she does a hit and run, a whole bunch of hit and run bullshit. So, we have to... Where the hell do we have to go? Defeat the Chosen. Oh, we just have to defeat the Chosen. We don't know where she is. I don't know if she's already on the map. Or if she... Or if she... Gets some... She just, like, appears after we get to a certain area. We're trying to do the old tile scanning technique to see if she's around. Because she will one-hit kill soldiers and stuff and then fucking run away. It's bad. It's part of the expansion, yeah. So I guess we're gonna move forward. That's what we're gonna do. We're gonna go forward. Okay. How about to here? We're gonna reload. Yes. We're gonna reload.
Reloading.
And Overwatch.
I await their approach.
I wonder if that's a bad idea. Oh, okay. Here we go. Okay, so this is where it gets interesting. It's all procedurally generated, their names and their strengths and weaknesses. So, Dar Mai Desurik, the Void Witch, pretty sweet, is immune to melee damage, that's her strength, and does not trigger Overwatch reaction fire, which is really bad news, because we're all in Overwatch right now. at least she's not immune to explosives. Takes increased damage from close range attacks, takes increased damage from Reapers. Okay, so we're gonna try and blow her the hell up. That's our plan of attack. Gonna get up into her face.
And I will end this quickly.
And try to end the fight before she can fucking murder the shit out of us. Yeah. Okay. I'm really nervous right now. So, we don't know where this biatch is. We're just gonna go forward. No, we're gonna go up this way. We're gonna maintain the high ground. I think. Well, see, Overwatch does no good, so we kinda gotta move forward. Or she will fuck us up. We're gonna keep this high ground for now.
I move.
So, okay, I forget how claymores work. So it throws a targetable environmental explosive. The Reaper is not revealed when shooting a claymore or when it is triggered. Oh yeah, I just remembered how broken this is. Okay, so that's so good. So, if we can keep her concealed, and then throw the claymore and blow up the assassin. That would be so good.
Moving out. Okay.
That would be so good. We're gonna keep her a little further back so she can not get revealed. We're just overwatching for now. We're gonna let the... Oh! Alright, we spotted her. Harbor wave? What the fuck is that? No! Don't do that! Dazed. Oh no! Lauren All is dazed. Revive dazed units. When soldiers are dazed by a chosen attack, they can be restored when an ally moves into an adjacent location and uses the free revive ability. Revived units have a chance to be destroyed.
We need to get someone over there to help them get back on their feet before that thing can move in and attack.
Right, so yeah, if you don't revive a dazed soldier, then the chosen will come in and fucking abduct that soldier, and they will be gone, still alive, but gone forever, until they can sometimes come back in a mission later on as like a mission reward. You like go to free that soldier. It's fucking awesome. So here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna get up this. Wait, I want you to get up this way. Because we can get close and do a shitload of damage close up. Because this skirmisher can take two shots in a turn. Because firing their primary weapon does not end their turn. So we're gonna really try here to just get up, do as much possible damage as possible. If we could end this on the first turn, that would be so sick. Don't think that's gonna be possible. But we're gonna try it. Okay, Lauren is disoriented. That's still not good.
I respect your loyalty to an ally in need. You will die honorably today.
We're gonna. I hope this isn't really bad of me to do. To get up and try to. I'm not sure if I should do this. How much? So, So they take extra damage, right? From close range attacks. Maybe what we can do is let's just give this a try. Let's give this a try. Come on. Do the thing.
Repositioning.
This could be a really bad move, but I'm gonna give it a shot. Also, I wanna know. It was extra damage from Reaper. Right. So how far can Where is my Reaper? Oh yeah, I put her back here. It's not far enough, not close enough. Shit. That'd be great if I could. Anyway, okay, let's see what we can do with our skirmisher. Real close, like. A pew pew. Brittle, takes extra damage. That's a critical. For 6 damage. That's nice. Again, Mox! Okay, so that's good. That's a lot of damage. That's 10 out of 23. I don't think we can kill her this turn, though. Grenades do 3 to 4. Let's fire the sniper rifle. Should we fire the sniper rifle, or should we get up with the pistol? Let's fire the sniper rifle. No, let's fire the... Yep. Let's give it a shot. Come on, baby. Go. Go and get him. Go and get him. Look at that. That's good.
I not expected this conflict to be so exhilarating.
Oh.
You surprised me, XCOM.
We didn't even need to do the full amount of damage.
The Elder's will is that
XCOM Jesus.
This day. I cannot leave that to fortune.
The sonic dispersal waves emitting from that pod are crisscrossing a massive area.
Meaning that thing just rang the dinner bell for every remaining lost in the city.
Whoopsie!
The entire lost biomass seems to be converging on this position.
So it's GTFO?
Let's get you all the hell out of there.
Yes, Fire Bradford.
On route to the evac coordinates now.
By the way,
get moving.
Bradford, Central Officer Bradford is the voice of, what's his face? From, what's that game called? With the guy who murks the Nazis. Wolfenstein! Yes. Blazkowicz, I think his name is? Okay, so we're gonna try and... We're gonna do the same thing. And try to get up into this building, I think. And try to get to the, up into that ladder. Oh, we have squad site. Is that a dasher? It is a dasher, okay. It's pretty sweet that we took down that,
closing on target position now.
That chosen nerd. And still have a bunch of actions left on our turn. Oh, that's a miss. That's a big miss. That's okay, though. That's okay. Everything's fine, folks. We're doing great. We're doing just great.
Heading out.
We are gonna shoot it. Skull. Make us proud. Damn it, Skull! Damn it! Okay. Let's get up over here. Upper.
I can get there.
Okay. Lost swarm is very close. Oh boy. Oh.
Initial analysis.
Okay.
Creature's movement patterns revealed.
So there we go. There's our answer.
They're not the mindless automatons they initially appeared to be.
They can't move and attack.
If not horrific possibility.
With the same action, they have to move adjacent to you then attack. So that's why we didn't take any damage. But this is good for a sharpshooter. we are able to dispatch of these nerds quite quickly with our little pistol. Okay. Oops. Lauren, you're still disoriented. That kind of sucks.
Moving to designated position.
Maybe you can kill this thing. No, you should probably just keep running. We're gonna take a shot with this. We're gonna justice this. We're gonna move forward and then justice league it.
Moving there.
Just to make sure that it dies. Oh! Okay, we missed on the 89% shot. That's not great. Okay. We're gonna take the sniper shot, though. I had 100% from up top, but that's only a 50% chance to kill, because he does 3-4 damage. So what I did, it provided a stronger statistical probability of killing it in one shot. And it didn't play out exactly how we wanted, but that's okay. That's XCOM, baby. We can still probably shoot this nerd. Still want to hold on to my, fire this pistol? That's a pretty good... You can do it. Come on, Lana. Frig! 68%. Miss. I would love to not have to use my, okay, there we go. This is the shot that I want. 79%. Please kill it. There we go. That's what I wanted. That's XCOM, baby! That's right. You guys are getting it. Alright, okay, so we can get most of us up this ladder right now. What? That's what we want. Come on, find the tile. There we go. Up, 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 up and away. Uh huh.
Watch my back.
There we go. Okay. So next turn.
How many of these?
That's X-Cone, baby! Oh, X-Cone!
Purifier squads into these cities for years, yet somehow the laws survive, even thrive. We do not know why.
Everyone just goes, oh no, what has he done? What did he just say? I'm gonna keep going through this here, yeah, like so. Just keep on running like hell. Although, we should probably kill this nerd, shouldn't we? We should kill this nerd. Lauren, do we trust Lauren to not miss? Do we trust anyone to not miss? And the answer is always no. but I think it's in our best interest.
Rolling out.
All right, well, we can at least take a look how... So can this nerd run all the way up here? I don't know. Do we believe in Lauren to take this shot? And then run the hell up? Do we believe in Lauren? No, take the shot anyway. Please don't aggro more. Lauren, we believe in you. 75% chance to not take damage next turn. Very good, very good. Okay, so we're just gonna keep running like hell.
A long run.
Keep on giddy up. Wait, where's... You can only just get up there, okay.
Closing on target position now.
So we're just trying to get up this ladder.
Mono keep.
Because I still don't think that the Lost can climb up the ladders. I think they can climb up the sides of small buildings. I honestly, I'm just not sure how it works now. Oh, they're gonna try and get up this other ladder. Yep, of course, of course. Classic. Classic big brain zombie move. Whoa! Fast as fuck.
I did not exist when this city stood whole.
Pardon me.
Still, I feel yeah. revulsion at what happened to this place, to these people.
I believe you.
This is, we're currently in the, remains of, Seattle. This is Seattle. Please shoot it and kill it. One shot. Nope. Fuck.
In reserva.
It's okay. That's okay. It's fine.
Nailed him.
Nailed him. Okay, so we can get over to this. We're gonna get over onto this platform. We're gonna try and go. Oh, wait. Is there a better way? This way? Yeah, we better go this way. Let's get on. Just bust down that door. Let's get in there.
Go, go, go!
Can we take a peek now?
In short order.
Shit, are there zombies that are gonna come up here? I think there are. How close are they? They're not that close. Okay, so we're still okay.
Allez, on bouge.
Okay. Uh-oh. That's a swarm. Cannot attack up ladders or across any full tile cover. Very good. Thank you for clarifying. It's been far too long. And I thought I read sometime that they, like, patched it so that they could climb up ladders because it's just too strong.
There will come a day when my people take back this place for our own.
If they are all like you,
thankfully that is not.
That is a likely possibility.
Okay, so, okay. Can you do this shot? I don't trust that shot at all. I don't trust that shot one bit. But if we do this fire pistol, there's a chance we can still have a move even if we miss. Let's try it. Okay. Not great. But also, we can just go like this. Like this. Some of us are at least moving forward. Don't miss on that 98. Thank you. Thank you.
No longer a threat.
Appreciate that very much. Oh, what the hell is this? Is this a zombie right here? Are we running into a room full of zombies right now? Doth my nubs bequeath me?
Moving to position.
Ah! It's right there! Oh, we just aggroed a whole fucking pod of those nerds. Oh, boy. At least we can... Lauren! How is your aim so bad at point blank? 78% with your gun at the zombie's face. That is so bad. Lauren! I'm not taking you on any more missions. Okay, thank you. Maybe I'll take you on some missions, but damn, that's fucking brutal. That is 58 aim is so bad. Because I have this mod called Not Created Equal, so all of our soldiers have random starting stats. Wait, how did you get over there? What the fuck? Did I put you over there? What the hell was I thinking? Oh, wait, what? I thought pistol shots were not turn-ending. Oh, fuck. Oh, that sucks. That is a mistake from XCOM Jesus, because in Long War 2, the firing the pistol... No, that's not even true. That's just a shitty mistake. Fuck it. Fuck it. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna block this. We're gonna block this so that Lana doesn't get fucked up. I think that's what we're gonna do. Anyway, yeah. Blocking it. Okay. And then we're gonna spend this turn getting the heck into position. Whoa! The fuck? Whoa. Oh my god. Come at me, bro. You can't get up this ladder. This ladder is for human living nerds only. Okay. Wow, that dasher is really quite a bit of a tryhard. Wouldn't you say so?
I advise caution. It would seem the lost are on to our strategy.
It is the Elder's will that this alliance.
Okay, so Lauren.
It will take more than mere.
Don't fuck this up, Lauren. 60%? You can do it. Come on. Nice, Lauren. That's my girl. Okay. So we're gonna get everybody in position so that all on the next turn, all at once, we can just sprint to the evac. I think we can do it. Yes, we can. We should be able to do that. Excellent. Okay, okay. Space Kid, you're gonna be okay, I think. Ooh, that might... Can you make it next turn?
Already there.
We will see.
Moving out.
Okay, we're gonna get on Overwatch.
And
Overwatch. Overwatch. Okay. That's a shot. Kill. Very good. Yep. Oh, Lauren. You missed, Lauren. Oh. Ow. Oh, shit. I just took out my contact by accident. What a disaster. Hey, I'll be right back. One sec.
Firebrand's in position, but the evac zone's even hotter than we thought. Running out of time here, people.
Tell her to hold as long as she can. We will be there.
Okay. Here we go. All better now. See, this is why I have 100 million hours in XCOM. Because I can just leave it on and then go, you know, do chores. I just leave this shit on, baby, and then freaking go about my business. Okay, so we can all make it, I think. Everybody can make it, right? Let's go. Yeah, I definitely didn't blink. That's my... Oh, look at all these nerds. Holy shit. Okay, so please run... Yeah, okay, no, we got this. We got this. All right, so we're just gonna... get some free experience. Just murder as many of these nerds as we can. Turn it on fast mode. Maybe we can use this claymore. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Placing explosive.
Can only she kill the claymore? I forget. Let's find out. Oh, no. Other teammates can shoot the explosive. Okay. So that's cool. So this... one of the Reaper's big shticks is this claymore that they can throw. And then they can shoot it, like so. Although I don't want to give that experience to Lauren. I want to give that experience to probably one of our snipies. Except we can't. No, we can't do it. Okay. Actually, I wonder if that experience even goes to... Oh, I guess we gotta give it to Lauren after all, okay. Okay. Everybody, run like hell. Okay, there we go. Yeah, I know. The contact thing may surprise you to know that I do have eyes.
We cannot hold this position much longer.
And they are improved with cybernetic implants. Made from tiny pieces of prescription. What is it? Plastic? I don't know.
No.
Rubber?
I do not intend to die this day. I will follow.
I have several eyes.
Vox Tala 410,
indeed. Nice. Oh!
When to return home, traitor.
Oh, bitch, got him!
No.
Oh man, they got Worf.
It looks like we'll be getting some help.
Played
from
by Kurt Russell.
I'd love to check out some of their weapons and equipment if we have time.
Bond available. Nice. Oh, dude, check this out. Space Kid and Lana got a biggity bond on the go. Ooh. Medical protocol or combat protocol? I intend on not taking much damage. Let's go with combat protocol. That's just how I roll, you know? Should we do it for both? Fuck it. Combat protocol. Stuff can't do damage to you if it's dead. That's what I say. That's my saying that I say. You hear me say that all the time. Definitely go with a long watch, I guess. Those are both kind of shitty perks. Whatever. Yeah, oh, the best offense is a good defense. Or is it the best defense is a good offense? I don't know. Hey, Ward Draws, what's up? Good to see you here. Yeah, that's a flawless victory, folks. That's a good one. And we got a bunch of intel and a scientist. Right. So, yeah. In the future, it's possible to free him in certain missions.
Advance officers might be more resourceful than an average trooper. But I doubt our forces will have any trouble bringing in a test
what?
For Tigan to look at. Especially since he's not asking for a live one. There's not a whole lot that surprises me these days, but I'm definitely curious to see if the chip we pulled from the commander really is connected to the one...
I thought we were supposed to...
...in their captains. The resistance factions can help us locate our captive soldier if we deploy on a covert action alongside them.
We may have chosen a different means of resistance.
Okay, yeah. But our people I thought I chose to reason. Start at the Templar HQ.
Together we will end this
That's a bit of a bummer.
Or die trying.
So I guess we won't... get
Commander,
to see
having these two soldiers continue to work together has paid off.
They my soldier
well
today. Bummer
that we can have them train as a pair for additional tactical capabilities.
Maybe it gets overridden by enabling that mission. That must be what it is. Bummer. So, hey Lana and Space Kid, I guess we're going to bond you. I don't know if that's a good idea. I don't know if that's a good idea, because you're two sharpshooters. I don't know. Not yet. Not yet. Yeah, I'm just gonna rush a Templar. Yeah, you're true, you're true, you're true. Let's do that. Okay, so... we got, two scientists already, which is pretty great. Let's let this cutscene play. Sibling, you know, sibling rivalry there.
Miscreants, restrain yourselves. Lest you be restrained.
No, the three of us called upon together. Something has changed.
On that, we are agreed. The battlefield has shifted. Our masters have need of us. Once more.
Sounds to me like they're afraid.
You dare defile this place with your wretched tongue?
Oh, I dare.
Kids! Kids!
Our children. Each of you possess our strength. Each of you possess our wisdom. Of all our creations, you are truly blessed. Your charge was a simple one. The subjugation of those who can see our grand design faltered.
These guys are with Advent.
Until now.
Advent is basically a facade for these guys.
Stolen from us, while our strongest did nothing. We are disappointed.
Thought you were the strongest.
Arrogance. Defiance. You have walked among the humans for too long. You have been corrupted. You can be reclaimed. Yet perhaps you may also be redeemed. Perhaps you all may be redeemed.
Hey, Josie, what's up? Thank you. Welcome in.
Our
time on this world draws to a close, yet we need not abandon it completely at our departure. For one among you is surely ready to claim this world as their own. One among you is worthy. Return to lost to us. Crush all who oppose our will. To the one who succeeds our everlasting favor. To the others. You are the chosen. Do not fail us.
Now go. Now go. I'll get you next time, Gadget.
Commander, right. We've just made contact with a new faction of the Resistance known as the Reapers. They're an elusive
This is their headquarters. Startup Templar HQ.
We can scan at this location now to start benefiting from our newfound cooperation.
So this is the Commander. Dragunova spoke highly of you and the rest of your team. Trust me, that does not happen often. You are all welcome here.
Okay, let's...
I will admit I had some concerns with this alliance.
See if I remember how this Resistance shit works.
...was captured protecting one of my own. Reapers have long memories, Commander. We will honor our end of the deal. Volk, out.
Tenacity could prove your undoing, Commander.
Chosen Revere.
You would seek a fight with me.
So yeah, there's a chance that Chosen will appear... on regular missions, if we go on missions in their territory. They're bad news. They're a bunch of bad news. They're bad guys. They're real bad guys. That last mission took freaking a long time. Let's go say hello to some nerds who have donated tonight. And let's see, where did we get to? Taki Uwu. Oh, thank you for the 6 months. Friday's Child with the 19 months as well. Wow. You're right. We probably will put Escher back into the pool. Or at least make them like an engineer or a scientist. Maybe we'll just make one of our scientists an engineer. A memorial scientist. You know what I mean? Egg Pebble. Hey, thank you for the Tuesday vibes. The 8 months. Thank you. Ari Suzumi. Thanks. 2 months. Welcome. Better late than never. I couldn't agree more. Infinity Break, what's up, man? You just got a keytar the other day? Hell yeah, you did. Red and black Roland Axe Edge. Nice, dude. Axe Edge. That's like the new better version of all reliable Fuck Thrust. Fuck Thrust, of course, is my my trusted keytar. Right on. Sorcerer Avery, thank you so much for the gifties. Tilafir for 15 months. Wow, thank you so much for being here. Hope college is going well. Mordekara, all those gifties, thank you so much. The Gregarious Fibula? Hey, thank you for the prime, eh? Oh, hell yes. Woodscrow in the 22 months. Hey, Woodscrow, are we gonna get you a soldier or what here? What's going on? Abby, hey, thank you so much. I'm glad you had a good birthday last week. you stayed early as well. Thank you so much. Yoshi, what's up? All right. Nice to watch it on a Tuesday. I couldn't agree more. Hey, Yoshi, the Shiba. You have a soldier awaiting customization. Right on. Hey, Scott. Scott Schuller, my man. What's going on? 14 months. Good to have you here, buddy. Skull, hey, thank you. I'm glad you're here. Excited for more XCOM? Hell yes. Good job on that last mission, by the way. Prisoners of the Ghostland. I do not know. Trailer says same studio as Mandy. Starring Nicolas Cage? Okay, you've got my attention. I'm going to have to take a look at that. That sounds very much up my alley. Ward Draws, thank you for those bitties. McDowell, appreciate it for the 7 months. Pun Princess, 11 months. Nethy, thank you. I recommend the game Death Road to Canada. You flee to Canada during a zombie apocalypse. Right on. That's like, that hits pretty close to home, honestly. Um, Lana, thank you for those gifties as well. Escher, why do aliens rarely visit Earth? Asks Escher. Because it only has a 1-star rating. There's those kind of jokes. That's what's going to get you back in the pool, in the character pool. Yeah. Right on. And Tiny Tuba, thank you so much. Got to rescue the cool character from the creepy purple guys. Seconding Escher Scientist. All right. All right. Thanks, Tuba. You know, we'll keep that in mind. All right. Let's see where we're at. Reaper HQ gain into the scan of the process studying for some time. Don't want that. I don't give a shit about that.
Prepare your forces for these difficult outcomes, Commander.
We're gonna keep scanning over at our soldier.
Avenger plotting new course.
Because we want to get more soldiers. Hey, thanks, Abby, for coming by.
Keep scanning.
We're gonna keep scanning.
Expectations.
New facility available. Yeah, we got our resistance comms. Training center instruction.
We made a startling breakthrough that has led us to another potential avenue of study. However, if we are to proceed down this path, we must do so immediately, or I fear we will lose our opportunity to return to it in the future.
Will lead to 50% reduction in the cost of building the training center. I don't think I want to do that right now. That's a big time investment for just a reduction in cost. I don't think I'm going to do that. No. We're going to autopsy this weird gangly alien called the Sectoid. Yeah? Yeah, because that way we can get psionic soldiers that can melt enemies with their minds. Let's do that. That sounds fun, right?
Though I was never witness to one myself.
Yeah.
Countless of...
Okay.
From my own experience, Advent generally deploys heavy security rather than subterfuge when it comes to protecting their primary...
Okay.
Commander, we can now work to establish contact with local resistance groups operating out of regions around the globe. Once we've collected sufficient intel to make contact, we'll need to scan the target region for the operative signal.
I'm gonna keep... Let's just... pick up the soldier, and then we'll start scanning, make friends.
Now operational.
Guerrilla Tactics School. Wow! Look, okay, so with this, we can train nerds to be specific classes. So let's take a look at our soldiers. And what their aim is like. Aim 65. So here's these are the soldier stats. Like I said, there's I've got a mod on called Not Created Equal that makes all the soldiers random, all their starting stats random. So 65 is like base aim, so that's average. Mobility, that's slightly below average at 11, because normal mobility is 12. So. Funkadelic Tessens, 55, that's kind of some poopy aim, but there's still a good use for those low aim soldiers in specific classes. Nethi is 70. I gotta fix your soldier. Base is 60. Metrolog 60. What's up, it's scary? 65. Okay, so I'm gonna try going with one of these
never had the resources to investigate the possibility
higher aim nerds to start.
Up outside the city centers.
Let's go with Nethi.
I have to admit, I'm worried about what we might find.
Yeah, thanks, Corb. If anybody here, if you've emailed me your customization for your character, I'm gonna get around to that before the next stream, but not right now, because I don't want to. That's why. So we're gonna train Nethi into Franger, yes. Wait. You want to be a specialist, eh? You know, Ranger should probably be high mobility. Anyway, so that's fine. Is there anybody that has more than 12 mobility? Ooh, Melusine's got 13 mobility. But really poopy aim. You know what? Yeah, okay, we're... whoops. So... what am I doing here? I'm clicking the wrong shit! You know what? Nethi, I think you're gonna be... yeah, let's make you a ranger. Okay. Oh, whoops. Yeah, you're gonna be a badass ninja, fast scouty nerd. But as it stands, we have a shotgun. Still waiting for an assignment.
We can have him working on construction, or staffing a facility. Commander, now that members of the resistance factions have joined us on the Avenger, I thought you might want an area where you can meet to organize and plan future operations together.
Uh-huh.
Commander, so far I haven't seen anything critical among the alien components left over in this area.
Whoops.
Clean this stuff out, we could probably use this space for a new facility. Excavation is underway, Commander, but it's going to take some time to get all that stuff cleared out.
Let's get this freaking soldier picked up. Beth Anderson, you're not in my character pool. Yeah, Rangers do rule. Holy shit, has it been 2 hours? Holy crap. Okay, so we need to make contact. So, what does it show?
Pay close attention to these chosen, Commander. They each seem to have unique advantages in combat that we should avoid.
Does it show the region that they're part of? I mean, I assume it's just this red one. So maybe let's... Should we go asking for trouble and just contact this region? It gives us slightly more money, because it's 85 a month instead of 80. Let's go Eastern US. Fuck it.
After we pay the initial intel cost to make contact, we'll have to scan the region for a few days before the local resistance cell comes out of hiding. Once we find them, we'll be up and running in the new region.
Commander, using intel collected so far, we've managed to locate a resistance cell operating out of this region.
Research psionics. Okay. Scan for their exact position. 10 Illyrium crystals.
Important step forward in our research. Right. The sectoid's rapid physical evolution over the past 20 years is a testament to both the aliens' mastery of genetic engineering.
I guess we're gonna go with modular weapons, because we can. That way we can
begin our research.
Start to upgrade our weapons. That's pretty neat. Holy crap, folks! It's been 2 hours. I'm not sure if these rookies are gonna go away, so I'm probably gonna scan them. I don't wanna, like, if I wait for too long, then they the point of interest.
We need to completely scan this region before we can establish contact with the local resistance. I'd advise we stick around to finish the job, but the choice is yours.
Yeah, don't worry, I'm friendly. Thank you, Coach Potatoes.
Got an urgent communication coming in for you now, Commander.
I had high hopes for the resistance under your leadership,
Mr. Voice
Commander,
Man.
And you have outdone yourself.
In a world.
Chosen are a tough group to infiltrate, but we've managed to gather intel on their latest actions. And have a rough idea of how close each is to reaching their ultimate
goal,
locating the Avenger.
every month we get a supply drop, and that gives us supplies. It also resets the black market and stuff like that, which is, and then it also gives the chosen bonuses every month. It increases their power like incrementally over time.
Commander, we have intel suggesting the aliens are working on developments that threaten our ability to stop the Avatar project.
Okay,
we can conduct guerrilla operations to disrupt one of these efforts, but we'll have to choose carefully. We don't have the resources to intercede everywhere.
Right.
Commander, the factions have pledged their support to XCOM,
nice.
And they're ready to carry out your orders. As our influence with these groups increases, our capabilities will grow in kind.
Things are going so well. Sounds like my Reapers can take on some new orders.
Yeah. Oh, okay, so we get, one free, so, yeah, this is cool, so, I remember now, the factions, there are three factions, right, there's the Reapers, the Skirmishers, and the Templar, they all have unique cards, like, you know, sort of, quote-unquote, cards associated with their, factions, and so you can swap these cards out to give you different bonuses, and, like, on the strategic and on the tactical layer. So, infiltrate seems pretty good for right now. It'll make our missions a little easier because there are mission timers, right? And this will allow us to get into position so that we can just break concealment and then the counter starts. Because I don't really need to pick up new recruits right now. So fuck it.
Commander. We'll need to send our own soldiers out to work with the resistance factions to complete these covert actions. They'll be gone for a few days, but this will help us build influence with the resistance while generating material support.
Right. Oh.
This operation is going to require some field.
Oh, yes. Location.
We'll need one of our vets to lead the effort.
We're gonna go to the Templars, baby. I can't do that though, can I? How do I do that? Available operations. Oh, but I need a sergeant plus. Fuck my lips. So we need to power level some nerd up to sergeant, Nice. Okay, so. Okay, wait. We're asking, is Gooby a chaotic alien? Or Gooby is... an alien overlord. Oh, okay, yeah. No, he's... Yeah, I mean, is Gooby from space? No, Gooby's from West Virginia. Have I never mentioned that before? Yeah, he's a rescue from West Virginia. But he is, one of the lords of the underworld as well. So, yeah. So the only one of these that we can actually do right now, because we all require a sergeant, is rescue Praetal Mox. So, let's go and do that. Soldier. So, I guess we can get a couple nerds, a couple rookies perhaps, up in there. Just get a couple of random nerds up in there, just, get it going like that. Get some experience. Yeah? Yeah. Wait. Sup, it's Scary. You here, sup? It's Scary? Alright, you're in. You're in. Okay, you're gonna get, plus 3 will. Very good. Okay, influence low. Unlock a mission to rescue Praetal Mox. Fine. That's fine. Let's do it.
We'll get the job done. Don't worry, Commander.
Commander. The Resistance has a hidden cache of resources stashed outside of Advent's reach. But
But that means there's a lot to do right now. Hey, folks. If we want to recover
this stuff for ourselves. Ooh, I better save this game. I keep forgetting that we're not playing on Iron Man. And Iron Man stream... wait. X-Corn. Wait, no. X-Cone. X-Cone stream. Right on. Okay, so... Everybody, I was just kind of doing this as just like, you know, for fun. Shits and Giggles on a Tuesday. X-Corn is pretty good. But...
I can't believe it's been 2 hours already. See, this is how
I have 1 million hours in X-Con. X-Cone. X-Corn. So... No, I am so tired because I woke up at 6 a.m. from a nightmare and I couldn't get back to sleep. It was like a Terminator, like a T-1000 was chasing me. I was hosting a barbecue. This is my nightmare I'm describing. I was hosting a barbecue in my yard, which was also in suburbia for some reason. And this T-1000... who looked like a tiny redheaded girl, was chasing me around, trying to murder the shit out of me. And so I was like jumping over fences, and it was like, I mean, it's the most ridiculous thing to be having a nightmare of. But you know, your mind decides like, oh yeah, you're scared of this, by the way, when you're in a dream, right? It could be the dumbest shit ever, but... No, there's probably not going to be a song written about a robotic humanoid cyborg chasing me through suburbia while I'm just like trying to cook burgers for my friends. your turn, internet. Well, you better lay off, man, because I got all these hungry guests. I can't cook them hot dogs if I'm being chased around by some murderous robot. Okay? anyway. Big Boy Monkey, thank you so much for the Prime. Welcome in. I appreciate it so much. And Couch Potatoes, thank you for those biddies. Pachira! It's so good to see you. It's been so long. It has been such a long time. You completed your vaccination yesterday. Hell yes. Congratulations. Because I assume you are still in Japan and the vaccination is getting underway there. So good to hear it. That's so great. Unfortunately, Pachira, I am actually about to call it on this. I don't know if you've been here or if you just got here, but I'm about to call it on this stream. This is the first Tubesday that we've done in a while. You know what? While we're playing XCOM and while we're enjoying it, I'll probably do it next week too. Everybody, we're gonna keep the goob time reserved for our very special ritual nights on Friday, because that's part of the ritual. That's the whole point of the ritual. I just want to say thank you all so much for being here. And you know what? I think it's a pretty successful Tuesday night. Yeah. So I will definitely see you guys on Friday. On Friday. You're just gonna listen. If I were to be given away Gooby time like it's going out of style, his stock would just get so low, it would just plummet. Gooby stock. I know you guys are all heavily invested into Gooby's stock, but you know it's all about supply and command, folks. So we got to pace ourselves with it so we don't oversaturate the market, you know? He would get chubby from all the chicken. He would. I have seen it happen. anyway, everybody, thank you so much. What are we doing here? Just like talking like there's not some perfect music that we could be listening to in the background. Yes. Thanks for this kind of last minute impromptu sort of ish stream here. Everybody, have an amazing week. I will see you on Friday on Ritual Night in the Cornzorn here, right here in the Cornzorn. Right on. Trying to think if there's anything else I should say, but I got nothing. Oh my god. Yes. I am so stoked. We are 100% raiding this guy. Not the sky, but a guy. This guy, and his name is Lyle. And he's the therapy gecko. He's not doing the therapy gecko right now, but he's fucking hilarious. Did I get it right? And therapy gecko fucking rules, right? Yeah, right on. Thank you everybody so much. And we will see you slightly later in September. Do you remember? Everybody have a great night. And we'll catch you on Friday. Right here. Same corn time, same corn channel. So long, and enjoy Therapy Gecko. Alright, take care everybody.